Thanks, Dave. Well, good afternoon, graduates of 2014. It's such an honor to be standing before you today because this is my first convocation as president of Algonquin College, the finest college in Ontario, if not in Canada. So we all have something to celebrate. You have successfully completed your chosen program, and I feel so fortunate to be here to shake your hand and wish you success. I do wish to acknowledge that this ceremony is being held on the traditional territory of the Algonquin people. Now, on behalf of the Board of Governors of Algonquin College, I want to welcome all of our graduates, their families, and friends to the Fall 2014 Algonquin College Convocation. I also want to welcome all who are watching this ceremony through live streaming. You may be here in Ottawa, but unable to join us here at the beautiful National Arts Centre, or you may be watching from around the world. You know, it's so impressive to me that we have students at Algonquin from 115 countries, international students who enrich our culture at Algonquin and in the Ottawa Valley. Perhaps family members are watching from those 115 countries to share in the pride of accomplishments that our graduates are feeling today. I also want to thank each and every one of you for choosing Algonquin College to complete your post-secondary program. We know that you had many choices, and we are grateful that you chose us. Now, I may be a little biased, and I know our staff feel the same bias, but I will say that you chose very well. Algonquin's reputation for quality and innovation is well recognized, and you should display your certificate, diploma, or degree with a great deal of pride. Speaking of this pride, I know you are joined here today by people who love you and who have likely helped you in some way as you have taken this journey, helped you with encouraging words, late-night phone calls to ease jitters, and, most likely, urgent requests for money. So let's thank them and tell them we love them. If you're a family member or a friend of a graduate and you're here today, please stand as you are able so that our graduates can show you their gratitude. Please stand up. Graduates, thank these wonderful people. Thank you. I also want to personally thank all of our employees, our faculty, staff, and administration at Algonquin. No one works harder than this fine group to support students, and this shows. You consistently give them the highest marks in student satisfaction for a college of our size. So let's give them again our show of our appreciation. Now, many convocation speeches that I have heard, my own and those who I've had the honor to attend, start with a quote. This one will be no different. It's a favorite pastime of presidents, I think, researching quotes to fit a certain situation. I'm going to quote one of the most famous, and certainly my favorite philosopher, Dr. Seuss. And I think this fits so well for you today. It's from a great book, Oh, the Places You'll Go, a book that I have bought for each of my three children and all of my nieces and nephews as they graduated from college or university. So here we go. Congratulations. Today is your day. You're off to great places. You're off and away. And of you who have read the book know that there is a message behind these seemingly simple words. Today is your day, a day to celebrate with your friends and family. Whether you came here directly from secondary school, after completing some or all of a university degree, or as preparation for a delayed or second career, you worked very hard to be and deserve to be celebrating. Take the time to be proud and to acknowledge the hard work and persistence that got you here today. And for some, the challenges were great. I faced some of my own a long, long time ago. I was the first in my family to go on to post-secondary education. My parents didn't finish high school, so I didn't have the role models and experienced family members to help me along the way. My parents couldn't afford tuition and books. Many of you here may have faced similar situations, and I am sure greater challenges than I did. But it's your determination that brought you here today. I salute all of you. You deserve much praise. You're off to great places. You are off and away. Well, here is where the future starts for you. I'm sure you are feeling excited, maybe a little nervous, maybe very nervous. There are so many opportunities for you. You may be going on to further studies. You may be already working. You may be searching for that dream job, but you're not quite there. Don't worry, it will come. I had great advice from a friend. If you're offered a job, take it. It may not be your dream job, but you'll be off and away, and who knows where it will lead. I graduated a long time ago with a chemistry degree, took a job that was offered to me in product development at a large international company right out of school. I stayed with that job for 2 years, but it wasn't technical enough for me. So I started looking and found a great job in a steel mill. That's right, a steel mill, developing new test methods and health and safety procedures. I was happy enough and may have stayed there for some time. Then something happened. As Dr. Seuss says, I'm sorry to say so, but sadly it's true that bang-ups and hang-ups can happen to you. Well, I experienced a significant bang-up. I was told that I was being laid off because of a turn in the economy. So I had to dust myself off after much feeling sorry for myself and think about my next steps. Maybe some of you did the same, and that's what led you here to Algonquin. I was asked to take a contract position teaching chemical technology and metallurgy at a college. I was offered a job, and I took it. I thought I would try it for a couple of years. Well, 30 years later, a master's degree through part-time studies and a career that has changed my life has led me to you as your president. A career that I would never have imagined when I was in your seat, waiting for my name to be called at my convocation. I tell you this story to give life to those words, you are off and away. It really means don't ever stop learning. Don't ever stop reinventing yourself. Your career is going to change in so many different ways as you journey through life. Algonquin has given you the skills to succeed along this amazing journey and is always here to help through continuing education classes, here or online, as your career takes you off and away. Before I close, I have to give you one final message that is so important to me. Graduates, there is more to your life than your work. I believe that we have an obligation and a responsibility to make a difference in this world, to give back to the community, as I know you have been doing while you've been studying here at Algonquin. We have been so fortunate in this great country. We have the freedom to speak openly, to study, to work, and I strongly believe that we need to give back as we are able. If every single one of us finds the courage and the conviction to chart a path of their own and to make a difference, we will create a better world for our children and our grandchildren. Another favorite quote of mine by author Margaret Mead says it best: never doubt that a small group of thoughtful, committed citizens can change the world. Indeed, it is the only thing that ever has. So graduates, I wish you much success, good health, and above all, happiness. Today is your day, your mountain is waiting. So, after celebrating tonight, get on your way. Miigwech, thanks very much.